Hello friends, welcome to this video lecture on influence line diagrams for a cantilever beam. In last some of the videos, we have seen how to draw the influence line diagrams for a simply supported beam and overhanging beam. Also, we discussed the applications of influence line diagrams to find out the reactions, to find out shear forces and bending moments at a section when the beams are subjected to dead loads. Also, we discussed how to find out the maximum reactions, maximum positive shear forces, maximum negative shear forces, also maximum positive bending moments at a different section when the beams are subjected to live loads. Now in this particular video lecture, we'll be going to discuss how to draw the influence line diagrams for a cantilever beam. Now as we know that in case of a cantilever beam, the one end of this beam is always fixed and its other end is always free. Now this fixed end of this cantilever offers reaction at A in vertical direction and one support movement at A. So we can also say it as MA, that is support movement at A offered by the fixed support. Generally, we neglect the horizontal reaction at A because generally this cantilever beam is subjected to vertical loads. So in this case, we'll draw the influence line diagram first for reaction at A, then for support movement at A, and then we'll go for shear force at a section and then for bending moment at a section. Now let us see one by one how to draw the influence line diagram first for reaction. Now if we see this now a cantilever beam whose one end is fixed and other end is free now, again to draw this influence line diagram for reaction for a cantilever beam, we need to consider a unit load. This unit load moves from A to B over this beam. Now in this case, the distance of this unit load is taken from right hand side of this beam, from right end of this beam, instead of taking from left end. The reason is that if we take this distance x from left hand side for further calculation for shear forces or for bending moments, we need to consider these unknown things or more things like RA or MA. To avoid that, we have taken this distance x from right hand side of this beam. So now we'll consider when unit load moves from A to B. Now when unit load moves from A to B over this beam, in this case, how the reaction at A varies. This part we have to see now. Now in this case, for any position of this unit load on this cantilever beam, if I take summation f of y is equal to 0, if we take summation f of y is equal to 0, we'll get RA is equal to 1. So now for any position of this unit load, when it moves from A to B, everywhere if I take summation f of y is equal to 0, we'll get RA is equal to 1 always. Now we can put end conditions here. When x is equal to L, that is at a point A. Now when this unit load is at a point A, as if you see this equation of RA now, it consists of constants. So it is independent of distance x. So at any position, for any distance x, everywhere we can find the same value of RA, that is equal to 1. So for this condition, for x is equal to L now, that is at a point A, RA is equal to 1. Similarly, if I take when x is equal to 0, that is at a point B, again we get RA is equal to 1. So it indicates that for any position of this unit load from A to B, means when it moves from A to B, everywhere we can say RA, we are getting it equals to 1. So by using these values of the reactions at A, we can draw the influence line diagram for RA. As we know that when unit load moves from A to B, the reaction at A will be same, that is 1. So here also it will be same and here also it will be same. So when unit load was at a point A, reaction at A is equal to 1. When unit load reaches to point B, again reaction at A becomes 1. So it is very easy to remember. It is just like a simple rectangle where the ordinates of this influence line diagram is 1, and here we have taken it as a positive. Now let us go for the influence line diagram for support movement. Now here in this case, this MA is nothing but the support movement. Again, we need to consider a unit load which moves from A to B. Again, we have to take the distance of this unit load from right hand side of this beam, that is equal to x. So when unit load moves from A to B, we can find out value of MA is equal to. Now if I take summation of movement about point A is equal to 0 in this case, When I take summation of moment about point A is equal to 0 in this case, I can take the moment of this one, that is 1 into L minus X. This distance becomes L minus X. It will be creating a clockwise moment. So 1 into L minus X, this is the moment, will be balanced by this MA. So we can say here MA will be getting as 1 into L minus X. Now here you can say that it is anticlockwise in nature, as this 1 will be creating a clockwise moment. So to balance it, this MA must be anticlockwise in nature. So in general, when this unit load moves from A to B, it depends, if you see now the value of MA, it depends on this distance X. So now we can put the end conditions here. Now when X is equal to L, means when unit load is at a point A, value of MA will be equal to 0. You have to just simply put X is equal to L in this equation, you will be getting MA is equal to 0. Now when we'll put next end condition, that is when X is equal to 0. So when unit load reaches to point B, value of MA will be equal to L. You have to just put simply X equals to 0 in this equation, you will be getting MA as L, and here it is anticlockwise in nature. Now we can draw the influence line diagram for support movement at A. So now if you see this now influence line diagram, when unit load was at a point A, value of MA is equal to 0. And when unit load reaches to point B, in this case, value of MA becomes L in this case. Now if you see this equation of MA, this is the equation of a straight line. So simply you need to just join these two points where you have 0 value, and here we have L. So you just need to connect it by a straight line, and we have shown it on the negative side as it is anticlockwise in nature. So in this way, we can draw the influence line diagram for support movement at a point A. Now let us go for the next, that is influence line diagram for shear force at a section. Now here in this case, the section at a C we have to consider, where the distance of point C from left end is A and its distance from right end is B in this case. Now just like we did in case of a simply supported beam, where we had divide this case into again two parts, when unit load moves from A to C first and then from C to B. So first we'll consider when unit load moves from A to C. Now again we have considered the distance of this unit load from right end of this beam, so this is distance X. Now first of all, let us see when unit load moves from A to C. Now when unit load moves from A to C, in this case, what is the shear force at a point C? Again, it is very much simple. We just need to take a section at a point C. If we take a section at a point C, and if we observe the right hand side for this particular case, we don't have any force. So you can simply say that shear force at a point C will be 0 when unit load moves from A to C. When it is moving from A to C, on the right hand side, we don't have nothing, means shear force at C is 0 in this case. So at any position of unit load from A to C, you can put any end condition here, you will be getting shear forces are 0 in this case at a point C. As we have considered the right hand side of the section in this case, to just avoid the calculation on left hand side. If I consider left hand side, I need to take RA once again and then I have to do this calculation. Better way, if I consider the right hand side of the section, nothing we have on this right hand side, and then you can simply say shear force at C is equal to 0 for any position of unit load when it moves from A to C. Now let us go for the next case. Now when unit load moves from C to B. Once again we have to find out the shear force at a point C. So for that we'll take again a section at a point C. Now when we take a section at a point C once again, and if I consider the right hand side of the section, we have one unit load acting in downward direction. So as per our sign convention, if I consider shear force at a point C, considering the right hand side of the section, you will be getting shear force at C is equal to 1. Again, if you see this equation now, it consists only one constant, so it is independent of distance x. So you can say that for any position of this unit load, when it moves from C to B, everywhere you can say that shear force at C will be equal to 1, which remains constant. So in general, we can say that when unit load moves from A to C, shear force at C becomes 0. There is no any change in shear force at a point C. And when it reaches to point C and when it starts its journey from C to B, the shear force at C becomes 1 and it remains constant till point B. So finally, by this data, we can draw the influence line diagram for shear force at a point C, where you can see now when unit load was at a point A, there is no any change in shear force at a point C and it remains 0 till point C. When unit load just start its journey from point C to B, now when it moves from C to B, the shear force at C becomes 1 and it remains constant when unit load reaches to point B. So in this way, we can draw the influence line diagram for shear force at a section. Now let us go to the final influence line diagram for a bending moment at a section. Now again, we need to consider the same case. Again, we have to divide the case again into two parts, when unit load moves from A to C and then when unit load moves from C to B. Again, we have considered the distance of this unit load from right end of this beam. Now here we have, let unit load moves from A to C. Now when unit load moves from A to C, once again we can take the section at a point C. Now here if I take a section at a point C, if you observe on right hand side, nothing we have. So you can say that bending moment at C will be 0. So you can say that when x is equal to L or when x is equal to B, you can put anything x is equal to for this particular position of unit load. You can say that bending moment at C is 0. So you can say that when unit load moves from A to C, everywhere you can find the bending moment at C is equal to 0. Now let us go for this next case, when unit load moves from C to B. Now when unit load, again it is moving from C to B, now we can again take the section at a point C. When I take a section at a point C and if I observe on right hand side, we have this unit load. So you can take the movement of this unit load about a section C. Now when you take a bending moment of this unit load about point C, it is 1 into this distance. So here it is 1 into B minus X. This total distance is B and this is X. So it is 1 into B minus X. Now it will be creating a sagging bending. Sorry, it will be creating a hogging bending. So therefore, this becomes minus 1 into B minus X. So this is hogging in nature. So now for this particular condition, when unit load moves from C to B, we can put in condition that when X is equal to B, that is at a point C, means when unit load is at a point C, again bending moment at C becomes 0. When you put X is equal to B in this case, you'll be getting bending moment at C is equal to 0. Now when you put X is equal to 0 in this case, that is at a point B, means when unit load reaches to point B, in this case bending moment at C becomes minus B. When you put X is equal to 0 in this case, you'll be getting bending moment at C as a minus B. So in general, we can say that when unit load moves from C to B, bending moment at C varies from 0 to minus B. And when unit load moves from A to C, bending moment at C remains 0. So we can finally draw the influence line diagram for bending moment at C. In general, when unit load was at a point A, bending moment at C was 0 initially. When unit load reaches to just left of point C, still bending moment at C is 0. Now when it starts its journey from right hand side of this point C and when it moves from C to B, now bending moment at C will be going on varying, and it reaches to when it reaches to point B, bending moment at C becomes minus B. Now here we have put minus sign only because of that the bending moment at a point C, it is hogging in nature. So in this way, we can draw the influence line diagram for a bending moment at a section, at any section, by taking this point A and B. You just simply need to understand its ordinate is minus b at a point b and its ordinate at a point c it is 0. So you just need to understand what is the distance of this point c from b, and the value of this point b is nothing but the ordinate at a point b. Thank you.